It's amazing. It's so fantastic. I mean, it's really such a special opportunity to be here. And so exciting for, I think, any art historian to come and be this close to the real thing.
We're some of the first people in centuries, maybe, to have been able to be so close to these paintings. And it's really, I mean, breathtaking.
In the next 2.5 years, the Grote Kerk Naarden will carry out a restoration of this immensely large painted vault. And they have asked us to help them with the questions that they have in this restoration. And that's why we've brought this group of 12 research master and PhD students to investigate what we can do with digital methods to gain a better understanding of the vault and to help the conservators in their process.
What we can do with these new techniques is really exciting because this hasn't really been done before in this way. We're making 3D models of parts of the panels and the paintings to really get that textural detail. Just the way that you can manipulate it, you can see those levels of detail and texture, and you can remove color, which sounds like a silly thing for an art historian to do, but actually it gives you a lot of information about the levels of paint, the grain in the wood. So it's really exciting to look at these paintings through new eyes.
It's just so amazing to actually zoom in on these really incredible tiny details and do research there, and I hope it's really valuable for the restorers and the conservators.
Roughly between 1510 and 1518 it must have been painted, but unfortunately the archives are lost, so we do not have any accounts or any written sources. So it's really difficult to say where we see the hand of the artist. Hopefully we can say more after the restoration.
Perhaps the most surprising thing has been signatures we've seen from the conservators who have been up here since the original artist made it. So we see every time somebody's made an addition, you know, they painted a little line here, they'll sign their name underneath it. Or in some instances, they'll even carve it in with a knife or something. And that's been surprising to see because that's kind of the sacred rule of art, is to not leave any marks.
This is the future of art history, and where art historians are going next into these digital reconstruction techniques is going to be really vital for looking at restoration and heritage projects in the future. Mm-hmm.